Sharing is caring. That's what my children say when they pick up my MacBook to watch YouTube. While we all love our families, sometimes we wish to hide some videos or pictures from our family members. Or maybe you have a roommate and you suspect that he or she is browsing your Mac while you are not at home. No matter what your reasons are, I'm pretty sure you will find the information I'm about to present useful. Today I will share 3 ways to hide files on your Mac. Let me know in the comments below which tricks you learned today, and please share some of your tips. My name is Al, and let's start with the number one, using the dots. macOS, like any operating system, has some system files, and by default, they are hidden from the users for 2 reasons. First, Apple doesn't want you to accidentally change or delete the system files, because if you delete or change the system files, your Mac starts working incorrectly. And second, when those files appear on the screen looks, the disk looks messy. But there is a simple key combination which allow you to hide or unhide those system files. So let's start the Finder. Now, it opened on the desktop. Use Command and Up Arrow key to go to the parent folder. Do it again and again. Now use a special key combination, Shift, Command, and Dot keys to unhide the system files. As you can see, there are many of those files, and most of them start with a dot. Now use the same key combination, Command, Shift, and Dot to switch it back. So this is your first tip. If you want to hide any file, all you need is to rename the file to have a dot in the beginning of the file name. However, it is easier to say than do. Let's take a screenshot and pretend that this is a picture I want to hide on my Mac. I use Command Shift 3 and I want to save it on the desktop. Let me switch to desktop. I want to rename to a short name. Now, if I try to add a dot in front of the file, look, Mac won't let me do it. But there is a workaround. We need to use the terminal app. Don't worry, I will explain everything in detail. So use Command and Up Arrow key to go to the parent folder. Right-click on the desktop, go to Services, and click New Terminal Add Folder. Now type the following. MV, it's a command. Pick one, PNG. Now we need to put the name of the new file. It's going to be .pick1.png. You see, the file disappeared. If you use Command Shift and dot keys, you can see the file again. Now you see it, now you don't. The advantage of this approach is its simplicity. The disadvantage is obvious. Anyone who knows magic key combination, Command Shift dot, can unhide the files you try to hide. So let's move to second tip. Security by obscurity. What does it mean? When I was a junior engineer, once I worked on the project with other senior engineers. Let's say that project was exporting some data to an Excel sheet. And as you understand, it's very easy to copy software from one computer to another. And what our company did, our engineers did, they added a licensing module to check if the software was licensed, and if it wasn't, it wouldn't run. So when I was reviewing the code, and I found out that the module which does this licensing calculations was called something like database utilities. When I asked one of the software engineers why the name was picked up, why it's not called licensing module, why it's called database utilities, they told me this is security by obscurity. Because if a hacker wants to hack this licensing module, the first thing they're going to look at is licensing module. They would not think that the licensing code could be in a database utilities. So we're going to use this concept for the second tip. So what we are going to do in our second approach is to change file extension. File extension is the last three characters after the dot in the file name. For instance, our picture has an extension PNG. We will change it to sys. Hit enter and change it to sys, like so. Use sys. Close the Finder, open the Finder again. You see, the picture has changed. Now, if someone clicks on the pic, Mac says, oh, I don't know what sys is, right? They may even think that this is probably a system file, and nobody will try to delete or change the file. This technique is actually useful in tandem with the dot technique I explained before. However, this method is not foolproof. Apple is not stupid, and even if you change the file name, it still knows that originally this was a picture. Let me show you. Right-click on pic.sys, click Get Info. You see preview? Even if we change the file extension, Mac still can show that this is a picture, and someone who's browsing can find accidental maybe your pictures that you try to hide. And this brings us to technique number three, using encrypted drive, my favorite. In the Finder, create a folder. Let's call it pics. Move your file into the folder. And actually, you can have multiple files with this technique, right? Now, you have to launch disk utility. You can launch it from a launchpad or use Spotlight Search. And I'm going to use Spotlight Search. Now, go to Menu, New Image, Image from Folder. Find our folder. Click Choose. You have to change encryption to 128-bit. I think it's enough. You have to specify the password. Verify. Save. Now close disk utility. And we see now there is a new drive. If someone wants to open the drive, they have to provide the password. Since I know the password, I can enter it and access the files I was trying to hide. By the way, don't forget to delete original folder, because if you don't delete, what's the point of this technique, right? And don't just move it to trash, because if you move it to trash, anyone can restore the deleted files. Use Option, Command, and Delete key combination to permanently delete the folder so nobody can find it. So this was the technique number three, but I have more. To learn more about other techniques, go to my site, macmythos.com, click on search icon, type hide, and here you can find 7 ways to hide files on Mac from family members. Enjoy!